so cool. The Magic Castle. Woo-hoo! Where the most famous magicians you've never heard of leave the safety of our parents' basements to astound you in the lap of luxury. This is the Playboy Mansion for 36-year-old virgins. Ladies, 37. We're gonna get right into it. In 7.5 seconds, this diaphanous strand of soft Egyptian cotton will be gone. What makes this a miracle? It's not gonna be hidden from you. If you watch closely enough, you'll actually see it dematerialize right in front of your face. Can't get out through this side. We're gonna block off the only way out of that glass so that sucker's trapped in full view. Ladies and gentlemen, I encourage you to lean forward. Please don't blink. Don't look away. Don't take your eyes off of that yellow. Thank you. Whoa! I had nothing to do with that. That is all the work of the spirits. And here they are, ladies and gentlemen. The spirits. Cheers. I sense the spirits are with many of us tonight. That's good. That's good. What is your name, sir?
Adi.
Adiz.
Adi,
Adi, that's cool. That's really cool, Adi. You're the first Adi I've ever met. Adi, check that out for us. Make sure it's exactly as it appears to be. You can go CSI on that sucker. Really, really investigate that, Adi. As Adi is doing that, ladies and gentlemen, as he's playing with that, the rest of us are going to get to play with the black balloon of destiny. I'm going to be honest, guys. Sometimes people get a little intimidated by the black balloon of destiny. I want to make you guys a promise. If you end up with this, you ain't coming on stage, you ain't doing anything crazy. I'm gonna ask you two simple questions from right where you are. Is that fair?
Fair. Yeah, fair.
Cool. So the object, when the time comes to stop, is not to bat it away, but to catch it. Fair enough?
Yes, sir.
All right, cool, here we go. Guys, keep the sucker in the air. Pop that sucker back up. Beautifully done, keep that going. Well done, sir. Oh yeah, way in the back where they thought they were safe. Excellent, somebody grab it. Oh, beautifully done. Did you guys notice that? No. One-handed, wine glass in the other hand. Not a drop was spilled. That was the most magical thing we're going to see all night, ladies and gentlemen. That was incredible. That's awesome. What's your name?
Linda.
It's good to meet you, Linda. Linda, 52 pieces of paper. 52. Oh, that was fun. Let's try that again, shall we? 52 pieces. Linda, would you prefer the red cards or the black cards, Linda? The red cards, the black cards. Red cards, I respect that, Linda. Linda, pop that balloon back up. She's the only one who's allowed to bat it away. There we go. Well done, ma'am. Beautifully done. What is your name?
Winter.
Winter, it's a pleasure to meet you. Winter, Linda said, I forget, red, is that right, after all this banter? Linda said, red, would you prefer the hearts or the diamonds, Winter?
Hearts.
I respect that. She went with the heart. She could have gone with the, I don't respect that. Pop that sucker back up in the air, please. Right back to herself, I respect that. And then, all right, somebody grab it. Excellent, well done, sir. Oh, did you see that defense? Wow, I respect that, man. What is your name?
Ricky.
Ricky, you are motivated, Ricky. I respect that. So Linda said red, Winter said hearts. What heart would you like? The ace, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Jack, queen, or king, Ricky?
10.
The 10 of hearts. That's phenomenal. Get ready to freak yourselves out, guys. This is pretty cool. It's the most difficult thing I do. Before we do that, I should mention we didn't have them like reach out, pick a card, any card, right? This happened entirely inside their brains. Had any of them made a slightly different decision, we'd be dealing with a completely different card. Had young Linda said black instead of red, we'd be dealing with a completely different card, but she said red. Had Winter said diamonds instead of hearts, we'd be dealing with, you said anything but the 10 of hearts, we'd be dealing with a completely different card. Ladies and gentlemen, this most difficult thing I do, it involves just one hand. For my good friends in the back row, I'm gonna back up so everyone can clearly see this. Ladies and gentlemen, the most difficult thing I do involves just one hand.
Whoa.
That just happened. One card. Had that been the Ten of Hearts, that would have been baller. It's the Ten of Hearts. But I know what young Ricky's thinking. Young Ricky's thinking, well, that's fun, Magic Boy. But it's just pure skill, right? It's something that could be done by any six-year-old with 27 years of practice. Y'all, it's a stock joke, guys. You don't have to laugh that hard. Y'all didn't get all dolled up and head up a hill in frickin' Hollywood to see something you can just explain away as pure skill, right? You want something that's truly impossible. Ricky.
Yeah.
Shake the balloon.
No way.
Did you hear that? Now, for those of you guys who are a little further away, here's what Ricky was listening to. Inside the balloon, the entire time, sealed, airtight, one playing card, which before the show had been placed inside neatly and precisely folded. And it is Ten of Hearts. Woo! But I know what Ricky's thinking.
Magic Boy.
Ricky's thinking, that was fun, Magic Boy. You made a handkerchief vanish, you made a cocktail appear, he grabbed whatever card we wanted out of the air, turned out a different duplicate of that card, and then folded up inside the balloon the entire time. But can he control fluids with just the power of his mind? Ladies and gentlemen, 3 hours ago, I consumed 2 pots of black coffee. And now... No. I only did that trick once at the Ritz-Carlton Moscow. Patty, you've got that, do you? I appreciate that. It was a long time ago. We have, Addie, this is good and solid it is as it appears to be. Is that accurate? No. Okay, cool. Ladies and gentlemen, controlling fluids with just the power of the mind. Do that freaky, far out there mind reading stuff. Ricky, stand up right where you are. Ricky, extend the finger. Now, it would be unchivalrous for me to read a lady's mind. Ricky, I'm going to invite you to point to any human male in the room whose mind you would like me to read. Anyone at all? Is it the gentleman with that nice teal? Yeah? Okay, cool. Ricky knew the color I was talking about. The guys didn't. Your name, sir?
Larry,
it's good to meet you. You can stop pointing to Larry. Okay, all right, cool. That's good. Larry, Ricky pointed to you out of everyone here, and now it is time for the human sacrifice. How do you think this stuff works? We're going to, with your permission, it's all right with you to reach into your mind, remove a thought without harming the surrounding living tissue, just kind of tear it out of there. Is that cool with you, Larry? That's cool. Okay, cool. Larry, we're going to hack into young Larry's brain. The thought we're going to remove is the identity of your secret 4-digit ATM pin code. Now, you have a choice to make, Larry. You can focus on your actual four-digit secret ATM pin code, and somebody here can go on a fun shopping spree. Or you can focus on four different numbers and keep your secret ATM pin code just between you and I. Up to you. But here we go, my friend, here we go. Larry, you've got four digits in mind? Excellent. Quick glimpse of the depths of each other's souls, Larry, right here. Perfect. Right there. Perfect, Larry. I won't share that with them. That's just you and me, bro. Larry and me. Perfect. Spelling it out. I am committed. Which, if you know any of my ex-girlfriends, isn't easy to get me to do. Larry, for the very first time, what are the four digits you were merely focused on?
0501.
You guys remember 0, you guys remember 5, you guys remember 0, you guys remember 1. 0501. 0501. 0501. Awesome, awesome. That's enough. Larry could have gone with any four digits. He went with 0501. Ladies and gentlemen, I have written down that exact number. Worship me. Yeah, Ricky, there we go. There we go. There we go. I'll be a little underwhelming for some of you. I respect that. Let's do this. Instead of me reading Larry's mind, Larry is going to read my mind. And you can see how hard it is. All right? All right. Cool. Now, we've been laughing a while. Let me quiz you guys just so at the end we actually have an end.
0501.
Well done. Just keep that in mind. Keep that in mind. Okay, Larry. I'm going to think of something. You're going to try and guess it. And you'll see how good you are at it. All right? Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. So I'm going to write something down. Just going for that Bloomberg money. Larry, here we go, here we go. So I'm gonna write down a thought. And a quick glimpse into the depths of each other's souls, Larry. Quick glimpse into the depths of each other's souls. It's only awkward if we make it, bro. Not the first time you've heard that. Larry, quick. Yep, there we go. And nobody gave you like $50 and told you what to say? You're not the guy? Where's the... Larry, I'll go first. So I was thinking, this is lame. Were you by chance also thinking that? It would be a miracle.
No.
Who was? You guys are a lot nicer than the last group. Awesome. Nicest crowd this week. That's awesome. So obviously, guys, I'm not a mind reader. I'm, as my Uncle Johnny would say, a fake, a fraud, a phony, and a cheat. But nobody's perfect. But I am a magician. And those of you who are very observant will have noticed 86 feet away from me. The entire time, there's been a little piece of paper in full view. Inside the paper, within the folds, painted in red. 0501. But I know what Ricky's thinking.
Where's the card?
Ricky's thinking, that's fun, Magic Man.
Boy.
No, that's right. I have grown from boy to man before your very eyes. He's thinking, well, that's fun, Magic Man, but can he do that smooth, elegant, beautiful sleight-of-hand magic? I grew up watching the TV specials from Lance Burton. Do you guys remember seeing Lance Burton on TV? He would do these things where, like, he would make a Ferrari, like, float out over the heads of the audience, or he'd make a UFO full of aliens appear right on stage. But he would always say that his favorite kind of magic was the sleight of hand. It's both the simplest, but also kind of the purest and most difficult form of our art. And it's the coolest when you can see it right in front of you. And there's a young lady, one in from the inn, in an elegant maroon, who's fear growing in her eyes, but you're going to be amazing. What's your name?
Jennifer.
It's good to meet you, Jennifer. And Winter, how are things?
Great.
I love it. I love it. I'm going to be honest. Jennifer and Winter, I didn't mean to single you guys out, but you guys seem poised. You seem confident. You seem reasonably sober. Winner and Jennifer, you guys seem like you would be incredible on stage. Would you mind joining for a moment? The people go crazy for you. I know they will. Winner and Jennifer, ladies and gentlemen. Did an incredible job for you here. It's true. They finally make it work out. Welcome, Jennifer. How are you? Welcome, Winner. Good to meet you. How are you? Winner and Jennifer, guys. Very cool. Well, guys, so this is, as much as it is the artistic sleight of hand, and it's a cool trick to kind of watch, it's like a trick, it's also kind of a training exercise for us. So if you remember the TV series Kung Fu, where the guy had to snatch the marble out of the guy's hand, you guys, Ricky remembers. Oh, yeah. Before he could leave the temple. This is like that. This is what I had to master before my teacher, Denny Haney, let me leave the temple, as it were. This is the ancient mystery of the little blue bag of secrets. Ooh. Winner, take a peek into the bag of secrets. Jennifer, reach inside the bag of secrets. Grab the bottom of the bag of secrets, slowly pull the bag of secrets inside out. Please don't drop it. Hold it for a minute. Excellent. So we have two hands. We have an elegant silk bag, the bag of secrets. And then the thing that makes this a real sleight of hand challenge and very difficult to work with. This hard winner is with it being a wide egg, they can very clearly see it at the back. You can hear it. It doesn't squish, squash, or compress quite solid. And my job is to try and sneak it in and out of the bag so fast the human eye can't possibly follow. Like a ninja in and out of the bag. So we'll do this under test conditions for the good folks who are back there. Winner, where is the egg? Excellent. And where is the bag, Jennifer?
Right in front of me.
Excellent. And where is the egg?
Inside the bag.
Excellent. And Winner, do you see the snow-white egg in the cerulean depths of the bag?
Cerulean.
Excellent. And Jennifer, can you feel said egg upon my palm? Do you feel said egg upon my palm? Right? And careful, it's fresh, but yeah. Excellent. And you guys can, what makes this really difficult too, and why I use the thin bag as a challenge, is you can always see exactly where the egg is. Ladies and gentlemen, the ancient mystery of the little bag of secrets. I'm going to invite you, Winner, give that a squeeze for us. Excellent, beautifully done. And from the outside in, from the inside out, seems to just kind of... But don't trust me. Winner, do you see the snow-white egg in the cerulean depths of the bag? Jennifer, reach inside. Run your hands back and forth. Do you feel the eggs? Jennifer, show them your hand. Perfect. Show them your hand is empty. Reach inside. Take the egg out of the bag. Show it to them.
No.
But now some of you who are very observant have noticed that the sleeves are carefully rolled up. The coat neatly buttoned. The dad bod sucked in. Fine. Oh, thank you. But to make sure that it's not like getting in and out of the sleeves, I'm going to invite you, Winter, with your left hand, if you would grab onto my right wrist and allow a little bit of freedom of motion to be like your Gumby. It's your Gumby. Excellent. Right. And I'm not intended to be, just to prevent it. Jennifer, if you would grab onto my left wrist with your right hand. Excellent. So here, for the folks back there, where is the egg? And Jennifer, where is the bag? And Jennifer, where is the egg? Excellent. And Winner, do you see the snow-white egg in the cerulean depths of the bag? She does. Excellent. And can you feel, Jennifer, can you feel said egg upon my palm? Excellent. Here we go, guys. The ancient mystery of the little bag of secrets. I'm going to invite you to go ahead and give that a squeeze for us. Keep on. No, do not let go of the wrist. Yeah. Excellent. So we got from the outside in, from the inside out, it seems to just kind of fade away. But don't trust me. Trust me as we come through there. Perfect. You guys are guarding very, very well at this point. Very intimidated. And do you see the snow-white egg in the cerulean depths of the bed? Reach inside, Jennifer. Run your hand back and forth. Do you feel any eggs?
No.
Jennifer, I'm going to invite you with your left hand. Make like a little L, like you're doing. Just like a little L, perfect. Excellent. Put the fingers inside, thumb on the outside, and pinch and hold that. Excellent. Winner, with your right hand, pinch and hold right there. So here's the deal. You guys are in full control of the bed. You're in full control of my hands. In fact, to make extra sure, Jennifer, lean forward, take a peek. Do you see the snow-white egg in the cerulean depths of the bag? No? Excellent. So you guys have the bag, you guys have my hands. In fact, we're going to do this with just one hand. Jennifer, grab onto my right wrist as well. Perfect. We're just going to do the right hand. Perfect. Perfect, guys. The ancient mystery of the little bag of secrets. Jennifer, I'm going to invite you to hold very firmly to your end of the bag. Winner, I'm going to invite you to let go of your end of the bag. Here we go, guys. I have nothing to do with that. That is all the work of the spirits. Well, folks, I'm going to be honest, guys. It is one of the great privileges of my life to earn a living doing what I love. It would not be possible without each and every one of you. I hope you guys had as much fun with me as I did with you. To you guys, cheers. Good night, guys. We'll see you guys again real soon.